So, good afternoon to all.
हाँ
Voice is clear? Good afternoon to all. So, in the morning classes, we are seeing about the CET level of the integration. In that, already we have seen all the formulas and the concept of the integration, right? And now we will see some Gmail level problems on the integration. Some national level problems on the integration, we will solve it. Okay, so first keep the heading in the Gmail level, that is the indefinite integration. So keep the heading as an indefinite integration. So in this indefinite integration up to the national level, we will have the same formulas, the same concept and the same procedure and the same substitutions only will be there. Extra, we have the two more substitutions and as well as one more method of the integration, that is called the reduction formula method, we have to learn in the Gmail level. The remaining all will be the same. But only the thing is that here the time is important for solving the problem and a little bit logic will be there in the questions. We should understand that on the time immediately to get the idea, then we have to solve the problems. So little bit logic will be there in the Gmail level questions. If you know that logic, easily we can able to solve the question from the integration. So for getting that logic on time, we required to practice so many problems of that level. Okay, that level problems, if you solve it, then easily we will get the idea how to solve the problem on this. Okay, so here we will solve some problems on that particular model. So just look at the first problem in that, which is integral x into under root 2 sine of x square minus 1 minus sine 2 times x square minus 1 upon 2 sine of x square minus 1 plus sine 2 times x square minus 1 dx. Okay, just observe this problem. So we have to evaluate this problem. This is integral x times under root. It's a simple question. So it is 2 sine x square minus 1 is there. Means here we can find that angle is half of the second angle. So here the second one, consider this is the format of sine 2a form. We know the formula for sine 2a, which is 2 sine a cos a. That is the formula we know. If you apply that formula, this is you can write 2 sine x square minus 1 into cos x square minus 1. We can write it. Means we have to make that angle is an half for applying that formula. Upon the denominator also the same is 2 sine x square minus 1 plus here again it is in the form of sine 2a, that is you can write 2 sine a cos a, that is you can write 2 sine x square minus 1 into cos of x square minus 1, we can write it. Now it is equal to integral x under root. So from the numerator, we can take 2 sine x square minus 1 as the common. 2 sine x square minus 1 we can take as the common. The remaining is 1 minus cos of x square minus 1. 1 minus cos of x square minus 1 upon. From the denominator also, we can take 2 sine x square minus 1 common. The remaining is 1 plus cos of x square minus 1 dx. Now, which is integral x times, here observe that this sine of x square minus 1 gets cancelled or 2 also is getting cancelled. Then remaining is root over, there is a 1 minus cos of x square minus 1 is there. You know the formula for 1 minus cos 2a, which is 2 sine square a. That is the formula we know it. So, this is you can write 2 sine square should make that angle as a half, which is x square minus 1 by 2 upon. The denominator is in the format of 1 plus cos 2a form. 1 plus cos 2a means that is 2 cos square a. For applying the formula also, whatever the angle is there, you have to make it as an half. So this is, you can write 2 cos square of x square minus 1 by 2. So like that you can express it. So where 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Now sin square by cos square, which is the tan square. Under root tan square, which is tan of. Therefore it is integral. X into tan of x square minus 1 by 2 dx. So this is the simplification of that given problem. X tan of x square minus 1 by 2. To evaluate this integration now, I will take let x square minus 1 by 2 is equal to, take another variable, say t. I'll take x square minus 1 by 2 is equal to, say t. So if you differentiate it on both sides, the derivative of x square is 2x dx upon 2 dx is equal to t derivative is dt, where 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Means the derivative of that x square minus 1 by 2 is nothing but x dx. So exactly that x dx you can find in the problem, that is x dx is there. So this is, you can replace by dt. Therefore the problem is integral tan t dt. Tan t dt. So the formula for integral tan t is log mod secant t. Which is log mod secant t plus c. So that is equal to log mod secant of t, where t value is x square minus 1 by 2. So log mod secant of x square minus 1 by 2 plus c. So this will be the final answer for it. Okay? So here the problem is not tough, but just by seeing the values you may get confused a little bit, but that is regular procedure only. So just you should get this idea that write that sign 2 as like that. And if you take the common, then this is getting cancelled. This idea we should get. Okay? So take the problem. Observe the next problem. Integral 5x power h plus 7x power 6, 7x power 6 upon x square plus 1 plus 2x power 7 whole square dx. So if f of x is equal to, if f of x is equal to this much, and they are given that f of 0 is equal to 0, then what is the value of f of 1? So f of x is equal to, this is the function, f of 0 is equal to 0, then what is the value of the f of 1? Okay, just observe that problem and give an idea. Tell me how to evaluate this. Any idea? So, the first step is that from the denominator, the maximum power of x is 7. So, I will take x power 7 as the common from the denominator. Take x power 7 common. Then it becomes 5x power 8 plus 7x power 6 upon. Tell me, if I take x power 7 common from the denominator, what we will get it? Take x power 7 common. Since here whole square is there. Means x power 7 whole square, that is x power 14, you will get outside. And if you take x power 7 common, here it is x square upon x power 7, that is 1 upon x power 5. Plus, second term means 1 upon x power 7. Plus 2 will be there. Whole square dx. Okay. Now, if you split this, if you split it, 5 into x power 8 upon x power 14, that is 5 upon x power 6 plus this 7 upon x power 8. This is the term we are getting. And this term sent to the numerator is 1 upon x power 5 plus 1 upon x power 7 plus 2 whole power minus 2 dx, right? Send this term to the numerator, right? Now, if you observe that, what is the derivative of this function? What is the derivative of 1 upon x power 5? What is the derivative of it?
1 by 5 into 1 by x power 4.
X power 5 derivative. I'm not saying
minus.
It. So the derivative of 1 upon x power 5.
Minus derivative. 1.
Minus 5 upon x power 6. Minus 5 upon x power 6. So the derivative of 1 by x power 7.
Minus 7 by x power 8.
Upon x power 8. Plus 2 derivative 0. So exactly the term is A here, but not the minus. So at the outside I will multiply by the minus and inside I will multiply by the minus. Then exactly this derivative is available here, right? Now this is the problem which is converted in the format of f of x whole power n into f dash x dx form. F of x whole power n into f dash x dx. So that formula we know that f of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. There is a formula we know it. So it is 1 by x power 5 plus 1 by x power 7 plus 2 whole power n plus 1. That is minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1. F of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 is the formula for it plus c. Integral constant we have to keep. So this is the value of f of x. F of x value is this much. So this is the integration of this problem. Okay. Then they have given that f of 0 is equal to 0. So the first condition was given. F of 0 is equal to 0. F of 0 means, so here you have to simplify this. Because directly if you get the 0, 1 by 0 become infinity. That's why first we'll simplify this. Minus 2 plus 1, which is minus 1. So minus minus gets cancelled. Here the LCM is x power 5 and x power 7. The LCM is x power 7. So that x power 7 comes in the numerator. So that is x power 7 upon. So then it is, here we will get x square plus 1, x square plus 1 plus 2x power 7 whole power minus 1 will be there plus c.
Power 1 only, sir. Power is plus 1. X power 7 upar gaya na.
Yes, sir, plus 1.
Power is plus 1. Okay. So this is that function. Now they have given that f of 0 is equal to 0. So if we keep that x is equal to 0 here, 0 upon something will be 0. So 0 plus c is equal to 0. So 0 plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, the value of the c is 0. Means that integral constant we got this is 0. Therefore, the function f of x is x power 7 upon x square plus 1 plus 2x power 7. This is that function f of x. Now we have to find f of 1. That is equal to 1 upon 1 plus 2, that is equal to 1 upon 4. This is the value of the f of 1. So this is the answer for it. Take that. Just observe here. So here in this problem, if you observe it, is integral sine power n theta minus sine theta whole power 1 upon n upon sine power n plus 1 theta into cos theta d theta. So to evaluate this, since here we can find cos theta function. So the derivative cos theta is the derivative of the sine theta. That's why, but first to substitute means that let it that sine theta is equal to t. So the derivative of the sine theta is cos theta d theta is equal to dt. So directly we will substitute that in the problem. So it is integral t power n minus t whole power 1 by n upon t power n plus 1 into cos theta d theta become dt. Okay. The problem changes like this. Now what we will do is this integral. So from the numerator there is a t power n and t is there. From these two terms I will take t power n common. With the t power n common, the power of that is the 1 by n. So at the outside you will get t power n whole power 1 by n we will get it. So t power n whole power 1 by n, that is the t we will get it outside. T will come at the outside. Remaining is 1 minus t upon t power n will be there. That is 1 by t power n minus 1 will be there. Whole power 1 by n upon t power n plus 1, I can write t power n into t, we can write t power n into t, where t and t is getting cancelled, dt. Right? So this is the remainder. Now, here 1 minus 1 by t power n minus 1 is there. Take that is equal to say k. I will take another variable. 1 minus 1 by t power n minus 1, I will take it as a k. Now we will differentiate it on both sides. Differentiated, the derivative of the 1 is 0 minus the derivative of 1 upon t power n minus 1 is minus of n minus 1 upon t power. You should increase the power of that 1, t by the 1. Increase that power, it becomes t power n dt is equal to dk. This is the derivative of. So, here minus into minus, which is the plus. So, divided by n minus 1, then we will get 1 by t power n dt is equal to 1 upon n minus 1 into dk we will get. Exactly, you can find 1 by t power n dt in this. 1 by t power n dt is there. Now, this problem becomes integral. This is not equal to t.
Sir, board blur hai.
N.
Yes, sir, board blur hai. Kuch bhi nahi dikh raha.
Nahi dikh
raha. Clear hai, sir.
Clear hai kya?
Whole power 1 by n plus 1 चाहिए.
हाँ.
Whole power 1 by n plus 1.
Whole power okay बराबर. Whole power 1 by n plus 1. 1 by n plus 1 means if there is n there, which is n plus 1 by n. N plus 1 by n. So in the integration there is some two standard problems are there, so which are important for the board level also. Look at those problems. That is integral x square minus 1 upon x power 4 plus 1 dx. X square minus 1 upon x power 4 plus 1 dx. So look at this problem, which is important for the board level also. So to solve such problem, what we will do is, from the numerator and from the denominator, take x square as the common. So from the numerator and denominator, take x square as the common. Then the numerator will get that 1 minus 1 by x square. From the denominator also take x square common. The remaining is x square plus 1 by x square dx. Where x square and x square is getting cancelled. Now, the numerator can find 1 minus 1 by x square. 1 minus 1 by x square, if you observe the numerator,
which is the derivative of x plus 1 by x. Okay, if you consider the function x plus 1 by x, if you differentiate it, x derivative is 1 and 1 by x derivative is minus 1 by x square. So 1 minus 1 by x square will be the derivative of x plus 1 by x. That's why. So the numerator, it is the derivative of x plus 1 by x. So the denominator, we will bring in the format of x plus 1 by x. Okay? To bring that, since it is in the format of a square plus b square form, you know the formula for a square plus b square, you can write as an a plus b whole square minus 2ab. Like that we can write it. So this is integral 1 minus 1 by x square upon the denominator, you can write x plus 1 by x whole square, that is a plus b whole square minus 2ab, 2 into x into 1 by x, we can write it. A plus b whole square minus 2ab, like that we can write it. So where x and x is getting cancelled. Now we will consider, let x plus 1 by x is equal to say t. That is the substitution. Take that x plus 1 by x is equal to say t. If you differentiate it, x that is 1. 1 by x is that minus 1 by x square dx is equal to the derivative of the t, which is a dt. The derivative of the t is a dt. So you can substitute there. The problem is dt upon x plus 1 by x, we have taken the t. So therefore it will become t square minus 2 is there. That is, you can write root 2 whole square. So the problem converts like that. Now it is in the form of, which formula it is? Integral 1 by x square minus a square form. What is the formula for 1 by x square minus a square is?
1 by 2a.
1 by 2a.
1 by
log of
x. Log
x minus a upon x plus a. T minus root 2 upon t plus root 2 plus c. Okay? That is 1 by 2 root 2 log mod t, where t value we have taken as x plus 1 by x. Substitute that t value there, x plus 1 by x minus root 2 upon x plus 1 by x plus root 2 plus c. Okay, now it is 1 by 2 root 2 log mod, here the numerator denominator LCM is x. So that LCM is getting cancelled, the numerator will get that x square plus 1 minus 2 root 2 x plus 1 upon x square plus root 2 x plus 1 plus c. So this is the final answer. So take the problem, and it is important for the board level also.